mention the person.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Assalamu alaikum dear students, how are you all? Parts of speech were continued and today we are doing the most important part of speech, which is prepositions. It has definition, it has uses, but mostly it doesn't have proper method where they are used and how they are used. It's totally vocabulary. As much you will learn, that much will be part of your vocabulary and you will use them correctly. But still, for some of them we have uses. Like, let's define. It is a word used before noun or pronoun to show its relation with other words. Wherever you have preposition, if you take the preposition out, you will get a meaningless sentence. For example, if I say the notebook is on the dice, if you take out on, that will be the notebook is the dice. Totally meaningless and senseless sentence. Commonly used prepositions are in, into, on, a, to, with, by, from, etc. When they are used after a verb, for example, let's take the verb look. When you change preposition after look, it will change the meaning of look, like look at, simply to look at something, looking at the fan, looking at the window. Look for, to search something. See, when it was there, meaning was something else. When you change preposition with the verb, it's for now, then it changed the meaning, and they are called phrasal verbs. It's also vocabulary. You have to see as many as you can and use them in sentences. Prepositions of time and place, like these three are the most important. They are used for time and place both. So here you have proper guidelines where for time you use in, on, at, and where for place you will use in, on, at. These are like the table given to you is from general time, bigger time, to very specific or short. Same goes for place, from bigger to smaller. Let's study in, the use of in with respect to time first. Like, it is used before centuries. For example, in the 1900s, before decades, like in the 80s, in the 90s, before years, like in 2007, in 2015, etc. Before months, for example, in March, in April. Before weeks, for example, in 5 weeks. Seasons, in spring, in summer, in winter. Period of time, for example, in future, in the past. Parts of the day, here different parts, some takes eight, some takes in. In before morning, like in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon. Clear? And on, now the same in for place, from bigger place to smaller. It is used before name of countries, in France, in Pakistan. Before the name of cities, like in Lahore, in New York, etc. Before enclosed space, like this is enclosed space, four boundary walls. For such place, spaces, like in the car, in the room, in the forest, etc. Before, now it's the time of on. On is with respect to time, for more specific time, like on weekend, see, centuries, decades, years, months, that is larger time, and this is specific. See, time, like on weekend, days, like on Monday, on Saturday. Before dates, like on 14th August and 23rd March, etc. Specific days, for example, on my birthday, and on Eid day. Day plus part of day, Like when both are mentioned, you will use on. For example, on Sunday morning. This is day, this is part of the day. So in such cases, you have to use on Sunday morning. Now, on for places before the name of streets. Like for example, on Ghazali Street, she lives on Ghazali Street. Surfaces, on the wall, surface, like on the board, on the table, on the wall. Means of transport and communication. For example, on a bus, on a train. Communication, like on radio, on TV, on phone. Now, eight. Very specific. See, I told you it comes from bigger to smaller. Now, for very specific time and for very specific place. For place, for example, at the bus stop, very specific location, like at the bus stop, at the station, at the airport. And how it use for time? Eight for very specific, like before the name of hours. For example, 8:05 p.m. Parts of day, as three were taking in, but midnight and noon take eight. At midnight, at noon. There are some uses of different prepositions. When they are used, like they have same meaning, like by, with, in, into, with, within. What does that mean and how they are used? So you have to differentiate them, like as much you can learn the rules, as they don't have specific rules. And let me show you, for example, pause the video and see them how they are different from each other. Then these I have given them in the notes to you, so you can use them properly. These are some of the prepositions. You have to memorize them. They are used with the same verb, like this page is totally different. You have to use them and memorize them, and then the same verb will take the same preposition after that. Okay, now we are doing uses of some of the prepositions. As I told you for prepositions, there are no hard and fast rules how to do them, because this is vocabulary and it comes to you by practice. Prepositions are used with the different verbs and they change the meaning of the verb. They are called phrasal verbs. But still, as I gave you about time, place, in, on, eight, so you can have some of the some idea from there, and you can use them correctly. Prepositions have no limit. Prepositions of direction, and here are some same prepositions which shows the difference. For example, by and with, both show doer of an action. And they are mostly, by is mostly used in passive voice sentences, who did the action. For example, the snake was killed by him, like this. So by shows doer of an action, but this is for person, and which shows the instrument with which the action is done. How? For example, by is for persons and with is for things or instruments. For example, the person was killed by a robber with a sword. See, with before instrument and by before person. Who killed the robber? Who killed the person? He was killed by a robber. Second sentence, see, the letter was written by him with a pen. See, with shows instrument, by shows person. So this is the difference of by and with, which have almost same meaning. Sorry. Number two is on, upon. Both have same meaning. See, on and upon. On is used before the noun at rest, and upon is used before the nouns in action. For example, he sat on the wall. Now the wall is not moving, it's rest. So he sat on the wall, not upon. Same, the dog sprang upon a fox. Now it was a moving fox, like running, and the dog jumped over there. So upon. Upon shows before the noun in motion, and on is used before the noun at rest. On is discussed already, it is used for surfaces, etc. In detail we discussed them under prepositions. Now in and into. In and into, if you think both shows enclosure inside something, but there is a difference. How? In is used with when something or someone is already inside. It shows state of rest, while into shows movement towards enclosure. For example, there are some things in my purse because they are already in. I am teaching in the class. You are sitting in the room. Understand? And for example, fish live in water because they are already in. And the river flows into the sea. The river flows from outside to inside. For example, a teacher is entering into the room, coming into the room, because she is coming from outside to inside. Or for example, I am putting my hand into my pocket. It goes from outside to inside. She is getting into a bus. Getting into a bus means she is moving into the bus, inside the bus from outside. She is getting into a bus and there are 40 passengers in the bus. Understand, the difference is in shows already inside something or someone already inside enclosure, and into shows movement towards inside. For example, the snake is going into his hole from outside to inside, or the inspector is coming into the hall. There are 400 students in the hall and the inspector is coming into the hall. Understood? The difference is like this. There are many, you can search them, you can practice them. I can show you exercise from here. Few I have given and half I am giving you exercise pictures. You can zoom that and you can practice them. Beside and besides, just S makes them different from each other. What is the difference? Beside means by the side of, like I am standing beside the dice. Maria sits beside me. Understand? Or the chair is beside the dice. The teacher is standing beside the table. And what besides means? In addition to, other than that. How? Like he was punished besides being fined. Two actions, see? In addition to means he got punishment plus he was being fined. Understood? So besides, this means in addition to some other punishment, like physical punishment plus being fined. So besides is used like this. There are some other which I am orally telling you, like in and within. Both are used with reference to a limit of time. In and within. But in indicates end of time in future. And for example, in within. Within, before the time, the limited time ends. Or in, it may extend to after that. For example, if I am going to hospital and I am writing application to madam that I will be back within an hour. Within means like that time is not over yet. Or in means like it may be extended to 1:15, 1:30, like this. And for the rest, I am just showing you exercise. Try them, and like some of them have try this exercise. These are like other than those. They are total 8-9 points. So some are given here, not possible to write all of them. So you can see from here. And for the rest, you can try these exercises. I am going to explain, but you just keep them in front of you. And I am going to explain because these are different. They have no rules. You have to memorize them like this. Like here, point one is, he is angry with. Angry always take with itself. Allah is kind to us, not on us. So you have to keep them in mind. When once you memorize them, it will be forever in your use. He is fond of games. Fond always take off. He is lame of one leg. He is blind of one eye, not with one eye. Blind of. What's the time? By your watch, not on your watch. He died of fever. Like, what was the reason of death? Died of cancer, died of fever. He is ill since Monday. The use of since and for. Since show fixed time, and for shows period of time. Like, for example, if you say she is suffering from fever since Monday, and she has been suffering from fever for 3 days. Same, for example, I have been teaching here for 25 years and I have been teaching here since 1996. He is unfit for this job. Fit for job, unfit for job. He lives 8's record. The use of 8 we discussed under time, place and in on 8 in detail. India is to the east of Pakistan, not in the east. I can kill 2 birds with one shot. I am late for school. Late always take for. He presided over the meeting. Presided over. Like whoever calls meeting has point to discuss, that person presides over. I am confident of. Confident of passing the exam. We warned him of the danger. Warn of, to warn someone of the danger. She is dear to me. She is dear, like my mother is dear to me. Dear to. He was married to a rich girl. He was married to. I met a robber on the way. I met my friend on the way. He ordered a new dress. Here no preposition is required. See, he ordered a new dress. You can say for herself. He is afraid of. Afraid always takes off. Afraid of. The beggar asked for alms. Asked for, to demand something. He is ashamed of himself. Ashamed of. Like when you do something wrong and then you have regrets later on, then it means you are ashamed of your bad behavior, etc. Attend to your lesson. Like you are attending to your lesson in the class. Allah has blessed us with many gifts. Blessed with. Allah has blessed us with. Like you can separate them by object inside, like us. Don't boast of your wealth. Boast of. He was born in a rich family and he was born of rich parents. Understand, got the difference? In rich family, of rich parents. He complained of headache. Like if someone has
headache and he says, oh, I am not feeling well, I have headache, it means he is complaining of headache. And one is, for example, when you report something like things are stolen in your class and you report that to the madam, it means you have complained about a theft to the teacher or to the principal. Understood? And complaint against, for example, if you are uneasy with your friend and she tortures you or fights with you, so you will complain against. See, complaint of, complained about, when you report something to someone, and complaint against means